Hi friends, let us today understand how an LTI systems are represented. So if I have a system to which I give certain output, and of course it will produce an output, then I give it some input and it produces certain output, and let us say that this system is an LTI system. But now, if suppose I don't know what this system does or how it functions, to know how a system functions is to apply a known inputs to it and see what is the output. So when we give a known input, it is called as excitations. Inputs are called as excitations. And when we see the output, they are also called as responses. So now onwards, I will call output as responses and input as excitation. Interchangeably, sometimes we will call outputs and input also. So excitation means the known inputs that is given to a system, or any input given to a system, and output is the response given by the system. So if I don't know the response of a system, or I don't know what the system is, like whether it is an amplifier or a filter or an attenuator or a storage element like capacitor or inductor, if I don't know what the system is, then what I will do is I will give a known input to it. If it is an attenuator, then I know that output going to get reduced. If this is an amplifier, then I know that it is going to get amplified. Okay, so if I know the input, if I give an arbitrary input, what will happen is my output cannot be determined. So I will give a known input, okay, and based on this known input, I will characterize what type of system is this. Okay, so to characterize a system, I will have set of inputs and set of outputs. Okay, so the known or the standard inputs that I will be applying is, standard inputs that will be applied will be delta of n, which is impulse, and u of n, which is step. So I have a signal called impulse and I have a signal called step. Specifically, they are unit impulse and unit step. So the height is 1. So I have a unit impulse, or I can apply as unit step. Okay. And the response that I get based on this is called as impulse response, which is denoted as h of n. We have seen this term h of n previously. I called this as a signal before, but this is actually a response. And which type of response is this? This is called as impulse response. And when I give an input as u of n, then the response that I get is called as s of n, which is called as step response. Okay, so when I give input as delta n, that is impulse, the output which I get is called as a impulse response. The input, if I give u of n, then output is s of n or step response. So my output over here, normally we denote using y of n. So now my y of n is equal to h of n, and here y of n is equal to s of n. So I will have set of inputs, that is x of n, and set of outputs, which is y of n, which will characterize the system. So whenever I represent a system, I will take set of inputs and I will give set of outputs, and that can be helped as getting a characterization of a system or representation of a system. Basically, LTI systems are represented using difference equation. What do you mean by difference equation? A difference equation is similar to that of differential equation, but differential equation is used for representing a continuous time signal, whereas difference equation is used to represent a discrete time system. As we have seen that the characteristics of a system is given by set of outputs and set of inputs. So difference equation will have a set of outputs and set of inputs and relation. So The difference equation in general is given as summation k is equal to 0 to, let us say, n, okay, ak y of n minus k equals to summation k going from 0 to m bk x of n minus k. So now we have a set of or a relation between the set of outputs and set of inputs. Now why I'm saying set of outputs and set of input is because I'm writing here x of n minus k and here also y of n minus k. What does it represent is if I put k is equal to 0, then I'll get y of n and x of n. Then I put k is equal to 1, I'll get y of n minus 1, x of n minus 1 and so on. So I have all delayed version of y's, that is outputs, and delayed version of inputs. So we have, if I expand this equation, I'll get a, let us say 0, y of n plus a1, y of n minus 1 plus a2, y of n minus 2 and so on and so forth till the last composite value comes as y of n minus capital N equals to, this is this equal to sign, then I have b0 x of n plus b1 x of n minus 1 and so on till plus bn x of n minus capital N. So I have set of input values, set of output values multiplied by coefficients. That's why this equation is called as linear constant coefficient difference equation. So sometimes it is represented as LCCDE. Okay, some text refers as that LCCDE. So it is called as linear constant coefficient difference equation. In this equation, we see there are set of outputs, set of inputs with coefficients. Thank you.